Sri Iyer, now to take it on the other foot, I have never seen until maybe the, it's not a direct comparison, but the scale of the intervention since the time of the India-US nuclear deal, where the top level of the administration is now sitting and talking to 130 of the biggest companies in America trying to figure out how they can help. Some of them are saying, oh, we have offices in Delhi. You can use them as COVID care centers. You know, we can organize the logistics. We'll get in the oxygen. We can. The U.S. Army is shipping in field military hospitals. What do you make of this? The scale of the response now, even though it might be a week later than we would have hoped for.
You know, spare a thought for the much maligned NRI community, which spent the last about 7 days calling up their local congressmen, women, senators, and anybody that they could get hold of and demand some explanations as to why U.S. was getting HCQ, which was a ban for export item from India. As soon as President Donald Trump requested it, India gave it. And then now when India has suddenly gotten this problem, it's a new variation, double mutant virus that people were just caught flat-footed, and it has a propensity to go aggressively spread. And what we are now seeing play out is many lives can be saved if oxygen is given to them in a timely manner. So this is the crux of the problem. It's not that India doesn't have oxygen. It's just that India has a problem getting oxygen to the right person at the right time. And I think this kind of struck a chord. A lot of people were in a lot of conferences over the last few days trying to urge them, say, what is the problem with us? Don't we have our own problems under control? Is it not true that until the world is rid of COVID, to the last person, we can never declare victory on this. This is a virus that has a propensity to spread so aggressively. We've got new terms like super spreader and so on and so forth. So it becomes the responsibility of every human being to make sure that this virus is got under control.
So let me ask a straight question before I go back to Ambassador Kapoor. Sri Iyer, a lot of people living in this country who have high hopes for the India-US relationship, but are equally gnawing at their skin, okay, when there are so many people, you know, who sit in such gross judgment that you guys are like Myanmar, you're worse than Ecuador, you're not even a partly free country, and who meddle in things that they should not be meddling in. For the people who get really upset at those kind of things, when they see the scale of the effort, now that is now being put, and hopefully as it starts materializing, the first plane load has come, more are coming tomorrow, day after, when they see the ICUs and the field hospitals and the concentrators and the cans and maybe even the vaccines, I'm told, are on the table. Maybe not a lot, but a few ready-made vials of AstraZeneca on the table. When they see that happening, how much of a long way does that go for people who say, listen, it's Russia and China who are your friends, the US is not to be trusted?
Look, this is all messaging by a small group of people who want to spread this fake narrative. I've lived half my life in the US and half my life in India. And I can tell you from the bottom of my heart, Americans are one of the most compassionate people in the whole world. They donate so much to all the causes. And it just takes time for someone to sit up and take notice that, my God, there is a huge problem in India and we need to do something about it. It's that wellness that comes from within. That's what has really mobilized this. I'm glad that it's better late than never. I'm hoping and praying that this week will turn the corner in India. And thereby, see, if you look at the United States, right? California is saying that by 15th of June, we're going to have completely normal conditions. Everybody has to wear a mask while they are outside, but all curbs are going to be lifted. Google is planning on bidding all the employees in by the end of this month.
Fingers crossed all of that happens. And, you know, we are 150 million doses down, and we are hoping if we ramp it up, just scale of our population doesn't hold us back. I'll again repeat, and I've told this to every single American I've ever met or known, we are not a death to America country. We don't burn American flags. We hold America up as an aspiration of what we ourselves would like to be, with, of course, our own cultural a significant that we bring in over 4,000, 5,000 years. But hopefully, with a bit of help, this logic can be told to the Indian people. You don't have to convince me or Madhav Nalapat or Ambassador Kapoor or Shri Iyer. In the end, you have to convince the Indian people that this is a reliable ally and this is a country that's your friend. And if the Russians show up with oxygen and the Chinese offer help and the Pakistanis are taunting you with offering for help and the Americans are saying America first, then that becomes a very difficult picture to sell. Sri Iyer, a quick last interjection, sir. What do you think the pull and pressure is? I'll leave the last word to Michael.
You know, we have to look forward, and what has happened has happened, but I think the Indian people and the Indian Americans now know which of the Indian American origin congressmen slash women slash vice president are really on their side of the camp. Only one name stood up and said we should do something about it. The others have been, you know, lulled by their silence. So this is what is the problem. They want the Indian American vote, but they will not speak the Indian American voice. These people need to be named and shamed. I don't want to name. There are not that many going around. Our viewers are smart enough to understand
what I am talking about.
Yes. So this is going to happen, but the tide is turning. You know, I have a daily weekday show for 15, 20 minutes where I'm going hammer and tongs at the administration with data. I'm not making any innuendos. So these are things that we have to keep doing. The messaging is going home. There were some people who are interested in grabbing the 1 billion market that was opening up in India, and that might have been something to do with this whole thing. And now the Biden administration is seeing its way clear. Hopefully this will continue, but I'm not going to hold my breath. I'm going to continue to work best of my Janmabhoomi and Karmabhoomi.
Well, all great things require great effort.